And there was a lunch sack, very small, brown paper lunch sack up there. Had some chicken bones in it. And there was a soda bottle sitting on a box. And we began then to search for a weapon. And we started toward, everybody took a different direction. And Deputy Sheriff Boone and myself just happened to head for the northwest corner of the building. And Boone was ahead of me by about 8 feet. And there was a stack of boxes just at the head of the stairwell going downstairs. And Boone looked over into it and said, "Here it is. Here's the rifle." So I immediately went over beside him and looked over, and there was a rifle. But we didn't touch it until Captain Fritz and Lieutenant Day from the ID department of the Dallas Police Department got there. Now, Captain Fritz was the chief of homicide, and Lieutenant Day was from the Identification Bureau. They got there and took some pictures of the rifle, and then I believe Dave pulled the rifle out and handed it to Captain Fritz, who held it up by the, had a strap on it. He held it up by the strap and asked if anyone knew what kind of rifle it was. Well, by this time, Deputy Constable Seymour Weitzman had joined us. And Weitzman was a gun buff. He had a sporting goods store at one time. He was very good at, with weapons. And he said, "It looks like a Mauser." And he walked over to Fritz. And Captain Fritz was holding the rifle up in the air. And I was standing next to Weitzman, who was standing next to Fritz. And we weren't any more than 6 or 8 inches from the rifle. And stamped right on the barrel of the rifle was 7.65 Mauser. And that's when Weitzman said, "It is a Mauser," and pointed to the 7.65 Mauser stamp on the barrel.
There's an intonation to that statement that it should mean something.
Well, the shells we found came from a 6.5 Italian rifle.
You mean those three cartridges?
The two don't relate.
Three cartridges that were
found at the southeast corner.
In the southeast corner.
Came from a 6.5 Italian carbine.